To get our website, we're going to use some of the best providers out there, which are GoDaddy and HostGator, and we're going to use coupons to get the best deals. Whenever you want to make a website, you need to understand that there are two parts to it, the hosting and the domain. You can get them both using the same provider, but what we are looking for here is cost effectiveness, so we're going to get them through different authoritative providers. The domain name is the name of your website, and the hosting is where your files are located on a server. Imagine that you make files that all together combined make up a website. Those files are on your computer and only you can see them, but by uploading them to a server, the whole world can see them. Later on, you're going to find out how you can connect your domain to your hosting server. With that in mind, let's get started. We're at GoDaddy.com and we're going to choose our domain name. I'm going to choose a random one, and that is New Year, New Me 2017. On this page, they're going to give us different options with different top-level domains like .net or .org. But we're going to get the .com domain just by clicking here, and then by clicking on Continue to Cart. On this page, we're going to say no thanks to this offer, as well as all the other offers, because we're trying to get the cheapest deal. Press Continue. Here, we're going to make sure that this is set to 1 year, and now we're going to add our first coupon code, which is the following. Hit Apply and proceed to checkout. Here, you're going to create your new account and you're going to be taken through a three-step process where the following is going to happen. You're going to be asked about your billing information as well as the payment method that you wish to use. Be sure to enter in correct information because along the way, GoDaddy might ask you to confirm your identity. Then you're going to place your order, and that is where the only thing you will have to do is enter in the code that proves you're human and then to tick the I agree box for the terms and place your order. Now this is where you're going to pay that $1 using the provided payment method, and note that the coupon we provided only works if you're using the particular payment method for the first time on GoDaddy. Otherwise, it won't work because this is for first time users only. That's it, you have registered your domain and you should be located on your GoDaddy account page. Now let's take care of the hosting. We're located on HostGator.com and we're going to buy that server by clicking on Get Started Now. We're going to be taken to a page where we can choose the plan which best fits us. I recommend you start off with the baby plan because you will be able to host multiple domains there rather than just one, which is what the hashing plan offers. On this page, what you're going to want to do is click on I already own this domain and enter in the domain. Then you're going to make sure that you have the right plan selected and that you have it selected for 1 month. Choose a username and a PIN. Now you're going to fill in the billing information as well as the payment method. After that, you're going to scroll down and enter in the coupon code, which you can find in the description. Click Validate after that. Uncheck any offer that they might be giving to you by default because we want to get the cheapest price possible. Agree to the terms and click on Checkout Now, where the following is going to happen. You're going to pay the bill using the provided payment method, and you're going to receive an email with the login information to your HostGator account and your cPanel account, which brings us to step 3, Nameservers. Log into your cPanel and scroll down to the bottom of the page, where on the left you should be able to find the Nameservers. In a new tab, open GoDaddy.com, log into GoDaddy, and click on the Manage button. This will take you to a page with all of your domains, and you're going to click on the one you just bought. To edit your name server, simply go to the name server section and click on Manage. From here, go back and copy your first name server, go to the Custom option, and enter Custom Name Server. Paste the first name server as well as the second one. If you have an extra, use it. If not, click on OK and click on Save. It's going to take around 12 hours before changes take place, so now it's time to install WordPress. WordPress is an open source website creation tool that allows us to create our own websites without any prior knowledge of programming or coding. To install it, scroll down to the Software and Services section and click on Quick Install. From this page, click on the WordPress menu and click on Install WordPress. Choose your new domain and leave this blank. Fill in all the details and click on Install WordPress. Press View Credentials and go to your WordPress login page. Paste in the password you just got as well as the username and click Login. Voila, you just installed WordPress. If you get a blank screen at the WordPress login page, don't worry. It usually takes around 15 minutes before changes take place. If you wish to find out more and to learn what you should do next, then by all means continue watching these videos, because we're gonna have a step-by-step video series that I know can be so helpful. If you already know how to customize your website and you want to find a profitable method that can make you money, then continue on to stoneracademy.com, where we can teach you all of that, and you can find the link in the description. I hope you enjoyed this video and have already taken action into building your first website. Till next time.